Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, Senior XD Evangelist at Adobe, and today we're going to take a look at the latest update to Adobe XD, which includes scroll groups, stacks, design tokens, and more. Let's dive in. Scroll groups allows you to define areas within your designs that can house scrollable content. With either individual layers, a group, or a repeat grid selected, these three icons within the Properties Inspector will create your first scroll group, horizontally, vertically, and even in both directions. The blue handles can then be adjusted to define the contents window, and when the prototype is previewed, scrolling within that area can take place. You can even nest scroll groups within scroll groups. This group of photos can be defined horizontally, and the map can be set up in both directions, allowing the content within it to be expanded, similar to a mask. You'll now be able to scroll within your defined groups, giving your prototypes a more real-world look. Stacks takes rearranging, adding, and deleting layers to new levels. With a component or group of elements selected, a stack can be enabled within the Properties Inspector, and XD will automatically determine the direction your layers are oriented, in this case, vertically. The various elements can now be shifted up and down, duplicated to add in new ones, or deleted, and everything below rearranges beautifully. New layers can also be created with your various tools, or brought in from your assets. Finally, the spacing between layers within a stack can be quickly adjusted individually by hovering in between two elements, or holding down Shift to adjust them all at once. Once you start using stacks to its fullest potential, you'll be able to nest them within each other to really streamline and speed up your designing. Design tokens allows you to label your colors and character styles to share them with your developers. As an example, my developer may request this particular color to be named Primary Green, this one Secondary Green, and the character style should include the appropriate header tags. Once all of your assets are labeled, select the development preset within Share Mode and make sure the Web option is chosen. Now, when your specs are viewed, the names will be displayed alongside objects they're connected with, and a new Variables option will be available to the right. Your developers will be able to view, copy, and download the provided design tokens. And that's a look at Adobe XD 30, bringing you new tools to help you design faster and more efficiently. For more Adobe XD tips and tricks, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you all soon.